Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's put our hands together and appreciate the Lord for these beautiful daughters of Zion. Amen, amen. Thank you so much, Sister Temi and your team. May God bless you and do you good. Amen. Are we blessed? Are we still happy? Or are we tired? Don't get tired because we are in the right place. Amen. And at the right time. Hallelujah. And so I want to bring back the praise team to come and minister unto the Lord. You know, the same praise dancers, they do different things in this church. They are blessed. The harvest is plenty. And so if you're a laborer and you know that you're a laborer, the harvest is plenty. Amen. So if you want to get blessed, please come and see us. We'll guide you and show you where to harvest. Amen. Amen. Because we are harvesting in this place every single day. The Lord has been good to us as a ministry. We cannot complain. Amen. We cannot complain. We bless the name of the Lord. I believe that as we continue with this conference, this is the first day. Miracles will begin to happen. And when your miracle happens, don't sit there and wait for the pastor to call you here. This is like the pool of Bethesda. When you are touched, run here and begin to dance and worship God. And if you want to lay your sacrifice, it's up to you. But when your miracle happens, don't just sit there and keep quiet. Be excited, jump up, come here and dance and rejoice. We are not a cult. We believe in the living God. David told King Saul, praise him, I'm waiting for you. Please, praise him. And so David told King Saul, there's something I have proven. I can't go to the battle with all this armory and all this clothing of the king. There's something I have proven that works. And that thing is the name of the Lord God of Israel. And even during this conference, there is something I want to assure you that we have tried, proven, and it works. And that one thing is the name of Jesus. And I believe that this conference will not be the same. Personally, I'm expectant. I wish you could open my heart and see how expectant I am. I want to receive. Amen. So this is a moment that you can't let it just pass by. Don't take this conference in vain. Let God open your inner understanding, the inner man, that he may see what is happening in this place. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We praise the name of the Lord. We give God all the glory. And so the praise team will minister unto the Lord. And after that, I will ask you to help me to bring our senior pastor. And as we always do it here, when the man of God comes, we stand up. Amen? Amen. We do that because we know that he carries the message from God. And so when the man of God, you see him standing and coming over, please just stand up and begin to worship God. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm the one supposed to be singing. You see, the harvest is plenty. Hallelujah. The harvest is plenty. Amen. And we are looking for more brothers. Please come and back me up. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to sing this song by Maurice Chapman. The song says, I will restore more, all of this and more. I will restore. Amen. Amen. And I believe God will bless you. Hallelujah. Taken unlawful, where the enemy has planted his seed. And when health is ailing and strength is failing, I will restore to you all of these and more. Restore to you all of these and more. I will restore, I will restore, I will restore to you all of these and more. I will restore.
I
For you are God and you are able, Lord, to restore. Lord, we pray that you may restore. For you are God. Arise as we bring our senior pastor. Hallelujah.
Is somebody set for restoration tonight? Everything that has been taken away from you, everything you've lost to the enemy, I just want you to lift up your voice, Lord. Say, Father, Lord, restore. Restore all that the enemy has stolen. Restore the lost years unto me. Whatever the cankerworm, the pandemic, the caterpillars have stolen away, Lord, begin to restore. Whatever I've lost to wasted years, whatever I've lost to wrong relationships, whatever I've lost in a wrong business endeavor, Lord, begin to restore all the years, the time that you sow into that relationship and the enemy took it away, but now the Lord wants to restore it back. Why don't you lift up your voice, lift up your hands and say, Lord, restore. Lord, restore. Tonight I am set for my restoration. But the encounter I shall have upon this mountain, Lord, there shall be a restoration. I am possessing my possession. I am laying hold on my possessions. In the name of Jesus. Everything that the enemy has stolen, anything the sons of wickedness has taken away, Lord, I am restoring. I am entering to my season of total restoration. By the power of God that worketh in me, in the name of Jesus. There's somebody here, you have come with heaviness in your heart. You have come with pain, but the Lord says, I will restore. The Lord says, I will restore. You know, in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 5 to 8, it says, Samuel encouraged himself in the Lord. And he inquired of the Lord and said, shall I pursue? And the Lord said, pursue, thou shalt overtake, and thou shalt recover all. And just like the Lord spoke in verse 19, he said, David overtook and he recovered all without fail. Hallelujah. Said David recovered her. I want you to put your name in that place. Lift up your voice to the Lord and say, Lord, tonight, by the encounters I shall have, even upon this mountain, by the Zion encounter I shall have, I will recover all. Father, Lord, we thank you. I want you to point to 2-3 people. Tell them, you shall recover all. You shall recover all. You shall recover all. Maybe nobody pointed to you. I want you to take your destiny in your hand. Point to yourself. I shall recover all. Whatever has been stolen from me, my God of restoration, I shall encounter him tonight in the name of Jesus. Just worship God tonight. Worship God tonight. This conference is about encounter in Zion. It is the encounters you have that causes you to possess your possessions. It is the encounters that you have that wipe away tears from your eyes. It is the encounters that you have that turns a slave boy to a prime minister. Encounters is what makes the difference in anyone's life. The Lord said to Moses, said, where you are standing is an holy ground, because God is in the house. Where you are right now is Zion. Where you are right now is God's tabernacle. Where you are right now is God's prominence. He said, I have heard their cry of my children by reason of their affliction by the tax master, and I am come down to deliver. I am come down to deliver. The Lord has heard your cry. That the devil could not keep you away from this conference gives me an assurance that the Lord has heard your cry. That nothing could stop you from coming into this city of the living God. I know that the Lord has heard your cry. Amen. And he will touch you.
Amen.
We are standing on holy ground. There are angels standing all around. Let us praise Jesus now. We are standing in his presence on holy ground. Is that the cry of somebody right now? Let that be your cry. Let that be your cry. We are standing
on holy ground.
On holy ground.
All around,
listen to torobo zundara malison torobo. Oh yes, Lord. Mason torobo zundara malesentere. Lesentere zundara malison torobo. Expect your encounters tonight. Expect your encounters tonight. Expect your encounters tonight. I want you to sing that song as if you believe it. I want the choir to sing it as if they know how to sing it. I want them to sing it with passion. I want everyone to sing that song because God is in the house.
Oh, we are standing.
If somebody can speak in the spirit, why don't you go ahead right now? Listen for the Zundara Male Sentere Zundara Mama Male Zundorbo Zendere Zindara Male Sontorobo Zundara Male Zendere Zundara Male Sontorobo Makale shindara male zundurbo zunda kale zendere zundara male sentere. Oh yes, Holy Spirit of God, we thank you. We worship you. We welcome you. Yes. Lift that body off our shoulder right now. Yes, that's one person with the pain. Let that pain disappear right now. Begin to start your healing in that body. Let that healing be permanent. Let that healing be made whole. Let that healing be permanent. In the name of Jesus. Male son torobo zundara mama. Spirit of the living God, unto you we are gathered. Come and move in our midst. Begin to impact life. Begin to impact relationships. Begin to bring healings, restorations. Empower your people. We are gathered here in Zion. Begin to impart out with your presence. In the name of Jesus. May no one leave this encounter the same way. May no one leave this encounter the same way they came. In the name of Jesus. Restore life. Restore situations. Restore relationships. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting King. Blessed be your name. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped. I said, for in Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped. Let's give Jesus a big hand. And we may please be seated in his presence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. People of God, I want you to set yourself for an encounter that will last a lifetime. I want you to set yourself for the impartation of the Spirit of the Most High God that will turn your world around. This is not a usual meeting. This is a meeting where destiny abath, where purposes begins to manifest, where dreams becomes reality. Whatever the dream that has been in your belly begins to manifest into reality even after this encounter in the name of Jesus. It is the encounters you have that determines the life that you exist in. Your existence and your manifestations is determined by the encounters you have. Whatever you have been carrying in your belly, you've been pregnant with it. The Holy Spirit is here to midwife your delivery in the name of Jesus. I say God is here tonight to midwife that delivery in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, I am not living the same way I came. I am not living the same way I came. Tonight is my night of encounter. Tonight, I am possessing my possessions in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Let me again welcome us to our first day of our Prophetic Power and Deliverance Conference 2021. Is somebody excited? If you want to clap, you can clap for Jesus. You can clap for Jesus. Are you excited? You are part of it. Are you excited? You are part of it. Then clap for Jesus. Because you are here this first day, the blessing of the first shall be yours. I say the blessing of the first shall be yours in the name of Jesus. I like to acknowledge the presence of our esteemed uncle and auntie Rita Enua, and Deacon Felix Enua. Thank you for coming to be here with us. Pastor Angie, you are mightily blessed. God bless you. God bless you. It is well with you in the name of Jesus. Let's open to Hebrews chapter 12. And we'll read from verse 22 to 24. And tonight we shall be laying a foundation for what the Lord is about to do. You know, in Matthew chapter 3, verse 3, said there is a voice crying in the wilderness, preparing the way. I am the voice tonight. Preparing the way for what God is about to do upon this mountain. Here with us is our guest minister, all the way from Tampa, Florida, Dr. Tade Owoyemi. God bless you. I know he's fully loaded to release that which God has for you, even in this service, in this conference, in the name of Jesus. So I'm here as a voice. Hebrews chapter 12, 22 to 24 says, but, somebody say but, meaning, no matter what you've been going through before today, no matter what the situation has been before now, no matter the stories of woes, the stories of unachievement, the stories of deprivations you have been sharing, no matter the mockeries of your life, no matter the pains you have been going through. But, somebody say but. You have come to Mount Zion. Somebody's story is about to change. I say somebody's story is about to change. Why? Because you have come to Mount Zion. Unto the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels. You have come to Mount Zion. You are in Zion. So whatever followed you into this place, he's not going back with you in the name of Jesus. Whatever situation trade you here has missed it. He is not going back with you in the name of Jesus. I come with a prophetic mandate tonight. And I speak as so sent the Lord. That the stories of your woes is coming to an end in the name of Jesus. Whatever has limited you, whatever has hindered you, whatever burdens you've been carrying upon this mountain, by the encounters you shall have, they will let you go by fire, by force, in the name of Jesus. Your story has been a story of one calamity to the other. Today you are happy, everything is going well with your relationship. The next minute, you are talking about we need to split, we need to break. Yours has been what we call up and down situation. But an end comes to that today. I say an end comes to that upon this mountain. The path of the just is what is like a shining light that shines brighter and brighter. You are not meant to have a better yesterday. The plan and the purpose of God for you is to go from glory to glory. Not from glory to pain. Not from glory to disgrace. The grace of God is what terminates the grace, disgrace in the life of men. And that grace is fully present here tonight in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, I will encounter the grace of God. Because I have come to Mount Zion, the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to an innumerable company of angels. In verse 23, he says, to the general assembly and the church of the firstborn. Who is the firstborn? Jesus is the firstborn. And this is the church of the firstborn. And which are written in heaven. And to God the judge of all. And to the spirit of just men made perfect. And in verse 24. It says. To Jesus. The mediator. Of the new covenant. I want you to take note the encounters you shall be having. You shall be having an encounter with the living God. You shall be having an encounter with innumerable company of angels. You shall be having an encounter with Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant. And you shall be having an encounter with the blood of Jesus, the blood of sprinkling. That blood that speaks better things than the blood of Abraham. So when we say Zion encounter, it is a multifold levels of encounters that God will be giving you upon this mountain. God will turn your story into glory in the name of Jesus. I say your story shall be turned into glory in the name of Jesus. The power of God is resident in his abode. And because God is here, you will encounter his power in the name of Jesus. We have come to Mount Zion. Get set. Get set. No matter where you started from, you will end up in glory. There was a story in 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 1. Talking about Samuel. He said the little Samuel began to minister unto the Lord. But the word of the Lord was very scarce, and there was no vision. The word of the Lord was very scarce, and there was no vision. There was no revelation. He was just ministering. Why they called him the child, the little Samuel? And that might have been the woes of some of you in the areas of your calling. As you ministers, the word of God is being very scarce. You don't even know what to say. You are not making impact. You are not seeing vision. You are just laboring. But through a series of encounters that Samuel had with the Lord, there was a transformation in his life. He had, after that, the Lord called out to him. The Lord called out to him, and he had series of encounters with God. And by 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 19 and 20, you know, he became a voice, and the people in the land began to recognize him as a prophet. Hallelujah. 1 Samuel chapter 3. We didn't change the chapter. Chapter 3, just go down to 19, go to 20, not 17. He said, and all Israel, from Dan even to Beersheba, knew that Samuel was established to be a prophet of the Lord. After series of encounters with God, he became established a prophet in the land. I say it is the encounters you have that establishes you and that gives you a testimony in the calling of God in your life. The encounters you have. So when you come to a meeting like this, you cannot afford to be casual about it. Because the word of God appeared again in Zion. That is verse 21. The word of God appeared again in Zion. 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 21. The word of God, this is your Shiloh. This is my Shiloh. This is our mountain of encounter. And the Lord appeared again in Zion. For the Lord revealed himself to Samuel by his word. God will reveal himself to you by his word upon this mountain in the name of Jesus. I say God will reveal himself to you by his word in the name of Jesus. Encounter with the word of God is an encounter that will terminate frustrations in your life. I want you to get set. I want you to be ready. Peter, in Luke chapter 5, encountered the word. He was frustrated in his calling. A professional fisherman, but frustrated. He went to professional fishing school. He had all the right certifications, but he was still frustrated. But he had an encounter. Verse 5. He had an encounter with the word. And he said, nevertheless, at thy word. The decisions you make in a meeting like this is what determines what you carry away from the encounter. The decisions you make. He said, nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down. And from being a frustrated fisherman, he became a celebrated fisherman. Because many other frustrated fishermen around came to help him to gather the fishes. And from being a celebrated fisherman, he became a fisher of men. And from being a fisher of men, he became one of the foremost apostles in his own time. Generational change, just at the instant of an encounter with the world. People of God, you know, I read about Smith Wigglesworth. At 45 years, he was just a plumber. But he had just one encounter. And he became a foremost faith apostle in his own time. I don't know how old you are. I don't know how long you have been struggling. What you need is just one encounter that will turn you around, turn your world around. So there's no disadvantage of time, because encounters bring the dimensions of heaven and it superimposes it onto your realm. No disadvantage of time. Encounters brings the dimension of heaven and it superimposes it upon your life here. There is no disadvantage of time when you have encounter with God. Let me tell you something. Encounters are available to everyone. Encounters are available. It is not peculiar to some people. It is available. But there are protocols for an encounter. There are protocols for you to step into that realm of an encounter. And I know that upon this mountain, the Lord will be revealing that protocols. And your life will not remain the same. My question to you is, have you had your own encounter? Can you say you've had your own encounter? One thing I want you to know is that every encounter begins with an hunger. Every encounter begins with an hunger in your spirit. Every encounter begins with a burden. God will put a burden in your heart. There is a drawing, there is a pulling, and the Lord pulls you to himself because he wants you to have that encounter. You know, we talked about Moses in Exodus chapter 3, verse 1. He said Moses was leading his father's lost cattle, and he led them to the back end of the mountain of the Lord in Horeb. There was nothing, no reason why he should go to the back end. But because it was the Lord that was drawing him, because the Lord wanted him to have an encounter. that day. Many times, God has put a burden in you. A burden that you need more of God. But because of our frivolities, because of our casualness, we have aborted the purpose and the burdens of God. Many times the Lord has said, I need you to seek me. But when it is Sunday college football, you lost that burden and you faced football and that burden leaves you. Is it wrong to watch college football? No. But college football has become an abortion. It has aborted the burdens of God in your life. And you will not go back to it. When God says, I want an encounter with you, He puts a burden. He puts an hunger. But we trivialize it. And we face something else. And we are saying, Lord, I want you to change me. I want my situation to change. And God says, I have given you what it takes for your life to change. But you have aborted it many times. You have let it slip through your hands. Sensitivity in the spirit is a mark of great men in this kingdom. I can imagine if Paul, then Saul, missed that encounter as he was on his way to Damascus. He will never be the most celebrated apostle of our time. I can imagine if Peter missed that encounter in Luke chapter 5. People of God, the Lord puts a burden in you for a reason. The Lord puts a drawing. It's a pull of the Spirit. A pull of the Spirit because He wants to take you to a next level. He wants to take you to a next level. When you trivialize spiritual things, your life end up being trivial. You have trivialized the things of the Spirit for too long. But each time you say, oh, I want more of you, Jesus, the more of you, the more I want of you. Each time you sing, but when God puts the burden for more, you trivialize it. There is always a price. The Lord, Jesus said, if you want to follow me, you must be willing to carry the cross. And you must be willing to let go friends and families and be willing to follow. The power of God is not for the trivial. The power of God is for the ones that are ready to carry the burden. Jesus said, everyone that are burdened, come unto me. Everyone that are burdened, how many times have you aborted the burdens of God? And the encounters you have starts with the burdens of God in your life. The power to change your story is in an encounter. But the access to the mountain of encounter is in your hunger. It is in your burdens. You know, sometimes it's just a song. And that song is playing in your heart. for 2 weeks. You are just playing that song again and again all over. The Lord is transforming you by that song. Sometimes it is just a line of scripture. I remember when I had my encounter and God took me to Romans chapter 8 verse 1. Said, therefore, there's no more condemnation for them that is in Christ Jesus. People of God, I carried that with me for so long. And that was where the beginning of my transformation. That was the beginning of my transformation. He said, there's therefore now no condemnation for them that are in Christ Jesus. For them. You know, that is a burden that I carried. You know, when God puts that burden, many don't know how to steward it. And they lose it. And they are praying, when shall my story change? But your story has changed many times. But you did not know how to enter. God gives you access for a story change by the burdens he gives you. But many, he said, the labor of the foolish wearied them because he know not how to enter. The labor of the foolish wearied him because he know not. The Lord has given you the body. That was your access point for a story change. But you did not know how to steward it into fulfillment, into manifestation. Many times, the Lord has put a burden. How many will agree with me? You have carried a burden in your spirit. But after some time, you lost it and there was no change. I pray for somebody tonight. When the Lord puts his burden in you, the grace for discernment and to be able to steward it even into performance, receive it now in the name of Jesus. You know, your life can be a constant stream of encounters if you can channel your hunger and prepare your burdens. And once you have that burden, the next thing is to lead you to a place of separation. To lead you to a place of separation. So that you can be filled with him. You need to separate yourself and deal with that body. Lord, what are you saying? The Bible says, you know, a man, having separated himself, intermingles with all wisdom. The separation, separating yourself unto the Lord. Many a times, the burden came on Jesus, and that burden pushed him into the wilderness. He said in Luke chapter 3, verse 22 and 23, that the Holy Ghost came on him and the Lord announced them, this is my beloved son. Many will think, oh, that is the end. He should start celebrating. No, he did not start to celebrate. Many of you, you have celebrated too early. It was time to be drawn into the wilderness. It was time for you to separate yourself. The angel came to Mary in Luke chapter 1, verse 35. He said, how shall this be? He said, the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and the power of the Most High shall overshadow thee. And what did Mary do? Mary separated himself, and he went to hide himself with his cousin Elizabeth until the day of his manifestation. That was the same thing John the Baptist did. He went to hide himself in the wilderness. You know, many have aborted the purpose of God in their life. Why? Because they celebrated too early, and they, instead of being hiding themselves until the day of manifestation, they were there posting on Facebook. They were there showing themselves on Facebook. He just proposed to you. He has not married you. Instead of you going into the wilderness to ensure that everything works well, or you are already posting stuff on Facebook. And before you know it, the powers that be comes to claim that which is theirs. Because you needed to go into a place of separation that you may encounter the power of God that will keep and sustain that burden he has given you, that will lead you to a place of restoration, to a place of possession. Many have lost their possession. Why? Because they refuse to separate themselves. And when you separate yourself, that is when you encounter God. Somebody say God. Somebody say God. Let me drop this with you. God is present everywhere, but God's manifest presence is not everywhere. God is present everywhere, but his manifest presence must be accomplished through a burden and a separation. Then you begin to see his manifest presence. Tell you the story of Jacob. As he was running away after he got the blessing from Isaac, and as he was running away to go and hide from his brother Esau, in Genesis 28, he got to a point, a place called Bethel, and he lay there, and he saw angels ascending and descending. And he said, surely God is in this place. The presence of God was there, but he did not carry the manifest presence. And that was why, even though he had the blessing, he was still a fugitive. He got to Laban's house. He was still cheated multiple times of his wages. For 14 years, he had to labor for a spouse. How many, who hears that you have to go to hard labor just to get married? But he was where God was, but the manifest presence of God, he did not encounter it. But when he was coming back in Genesis chapter 32, and he said in verse 24 to 28, and he met God again. But there was a burden in his heart. There was a fire in his heart. And he said, I will not let you go. I will not let you go. You need to reveal yourself to me. You need to show yourself to me. He said they labor until the dawn of the morning. And the angel said, okay, what is your name? Why wasn't he asked that question in Genesis 28? Because he did not carry the burden. He did not carry the passion. The passion was not there. And he said, I am Jacob. He said, no. Thou shalt no longer be Jacob. For with man, he said, thou hast prevailed with man, with God and with man. Hallelujah. You must be willing to allow the manifest presence of God transform your life. And that's why many people can come to a meeting, but not everyone is blessed in that meeting. God was there, but only his manifest presence is specific to those that desires it. That's where you hear people sharing testimonies and you are saying, God, we are in the same message, we are in the same church, they are sharing their, why is my own going to come? Lift up your hand and say, Lord, I desire your manifest presence upon this mountain. I am not living here without carrying your manifest presence with me. In Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. It said, they that wait on the Lord, he shall renew their strength. The process of separation is the process of waiting. Let your burden take you to a place of waiting on the Lord. Let your burden. And that was why, as a ministry, we started a 21-day prayer and fasting. You know, God will always reveal his purpose to his messengers. He would never do a thing without revealing it. And he told me, ask my sons, to go into a time of waiting on me. The Lord released and said, I am set for an encounter with power. That is a burden that everyone in this ministry should be carrying. And where is that burden pushing you? Is it pushing you to go and be watching college football? Is it drawn to watch college football? Like I said, no. But it has aborted many burdens and many purposes. I have nothing against football. But I know football is on Sunday. And many times you are supposed to be in church, but you are at home watching college football. He said, if you faint in the days of adversity, thy strength is small. For you not to faint, you need to encounter power. And power can only be encountered by the manifest presence of God. Moses encountered that manifest presence after 40 days. After 40 days, the manifest presence of God appeared to Moses. For somebody here, it might be just 3 days. Maybe you are counting day one today. But let that burden be in you. Don't be careless. Because God will be putting burdens in your heart, even as I'm speaking right now. God is putting burdens in your heart. God is putting burdens in your heart. May you not trivialize it. May you not abort it in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 84 verse 7, said they go from strength to strength as many that appear before God in Zion. Where are you? I say, where are you? I say, where are you? When we talk about strength, that is power. Power. Power to do work. Power. Ability to shift mountains. Ability to turn situations around. Regardless of who is standing in the way. You may not have control about where they stand. But you know, have control of where you are going. If they are standing in your way, you shift them away. In Psalm 66, it said, through the greatness of thy power, Psalm 66 verse 5, I want to believe, shall your enemies submit themselves. He said, how terrible are thy works. In verse 6, through the greatness of thy power, shall your enemies submit themselves unto you. Psalm 66, verse 3. Start from verse 3. So that, say unto the Lord, how terrible are thy works, through the greatness of thy power. So, enough of talking about what the enemy is doing. Go for power. When you go for power, you don't need to talk. Your explanation is too much. Your excuses are too much. You will no longer be talking. You will be walking. Somebody say walking. Enough of talking, explaining, explanation. People are tired of your explanation. But it is in the place of the manifest presence of God that you encounter power for work. So if you are here tonight and you are under the influence of my voice, you are not here by accident. I say you are not here by accident. God wants to begin to take you on a journey that will take you to your next level. And nothing the enemy does will be able to stop you. He said in Romans chapter 8 verse 19, the earnest expectation of the creation is waiting for your manifestation, not waiting for your explanation. They are tired of too much explanation. It is time for you to arise and shine. When light shows up, it does not complain about darkness. Darkness knows to leave. How terrible are thy works, through the greatness of thy power, shall the enemy submit themselves. You know, the Bible says the word that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. This word does not profit you if it is not been empowered by the manifest presence of God. And that is why you come to church day and night and you just receive the word and you go and it does not change you. It is the power in the word that is able to transform. He said, in John, that the word became flesh and he came to dwell with us. It takes the power of God, the manifest presence of God, to turn the word into power. And after tonight, whatever prophecy has been released upon you that is yet to manifest, by the manifest presence of God, you begin to carry your blessings. You begin to carry your blessing. You begin to carry your blessings. You begin to carry your blessing. I see the Holy Ghost converting every word into manifestations. You have carried those prophecies for too long. The truth is, only God dwells in the realms of the spirit, and he gives blessings in the spirit, but we dwell in the realm of the physical and we enjoy the blessings in the physical. So there must be a conversion of that spirit blessing into tangible blessing. We dwell in tangibility. It is the manifest presence of God that converts the prophetic word in the spirit realm to tangible blessing in the natural realm. And that is the encounter you are set to have. That you cannot escape these 3 days and you remain who you are. Because God wants to take you to another level. And I can see it is happening right now. I can see it is happening right now. Something God is working already. I say my God is working in you to do of his own pleasure. I have come to you as a man sent for a season like this. I'm here to share the truth with you. I'm not here to hype on your sentiments. You have been who you are all this time because you have not coveted the manifest presence of God. And the word became flesh and it dwelt among men. Jacob encountered the manifest presence of God and the blessings manifested, and the angel said, "What is your name? You shall no longer be called Jacob, but Israel. For as a prince thou hast power with God and with man, and hast prevailed." No wonder in Isaiah chapter 9 verse 8, he said he sent his word unto Jacob and he lighted upon Israel. He sent the word, and by divine encounter, that word transformed him into a generational blessing. He has been receiving the word as Jacob and he never blessed him. But by the encounter he had, he was transformed into Israel. The Lord sent a word unto Jacob and he lighted. What is light? Revelation. Word plus the spirit of God is revelation. And that is light. Oh, somebody is living here with revelations. Is living here with a new sense of purpose. Is living here with a new sense of manifestation. In the name of Jesus. Somebody is living here, a changed man. A changed man. In the name of Jesus. I will say this. It might negate everything that you knew before, but take it in the spirit of revelation. In Exodus chapter 3 that we read, we saw the Lord called out to Moses. He said the fire was burning, but the bush was not consumed. God was present, but the manifest presence of God was not there. Because I know my God, according to Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29, that my God is a consuming fire. My God is a... So how can God be there and it's not consuming? Why? The manifest presence of God was not there. No wonder Moses was given every excuse in this world why he could not be sent of God. Moses was given every excuse. The burden was not in his heart. He wanted to abort it. But thank God for grace. Somebody say grace. Somebody say grace. God did not allow him to abort his blessing. God did not allow him to abort his purpose. Said the fire was burning. God was there. But it was not manifesting. Elisha carried God, but he still died anyhow. And he was the only one, Elisha, because he was so selfish. He did not want to give the spirit, he didn't want to pass the torch to anyone. No one around him was able to carry the torch like he took it from Elijah. And he took it into grave with him. No wonder when he died and they threw him into the grave, the same, they now threw, by mistake, threw a corpse into that grave, and that corpse became alive. The manifest presence of God manifested in him. Why? Because he was dead to self. Now he was already dead to his selfishness. And that is one thing you need. You need to be dead to self and only alive to God for you to carry the manifest presence of God. Paul said, "For me to die is gain, and to live is Christ. I am crucified with Christ, but yet not I that live, but I live by faith for Christ." Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. Somebody tell your neighbor you are too full of yourself. That is why God is not manifesting. You are too full of yourself. You are too conscious of yourself. You are too conscious of yourself. I'm sorry, I'm going deep beyond, but that is what meetings like these are for. It is not for the surface. It is to excavate mysteries. Remember the story of Elisha? When he was on his sick bed, they came to him so that he can pass the torch. In 2 Kings, chapter 13, verse 14 to 20. But he was telling him to throw the arrow. To draw the arrow. Okay. And after he drew the arrow, because of anger, he refused to pass on the mantle. And there he died with it. Gehazi missed it. I believe Joab was the one that now went to him to try to get it from him again. And he said, oh, I told you to shoot. Did I tell you to stop shooting the arrow? Because of anger, he refused. And he died with the mantle. But the mantle did not keep him alive, just like his master, Elijah. Elijah was taken. He did not die. But Elisha died because the manifest presence of God was not activated because he was too full of self. But when he died, that spirit, manifest presence of God, manifested, and the dead was made to rise. For you to experience the power of God, you must be dead to yourself. Many people are too conscious of themselves, and so God cannot touch them. God cannot touch them. The Bible says in Romans chapter 8, verse 11, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwells in you. I pray for somebody here tonight. I see the manifested presence of God give life to every dying or dead situations or organs in your life now, in the name of Jesus. Whatever the doctors might have called it, whatever name they might have called it, the manifest presence of God begins to resurrect life back into those organs in the name of Jesus. May your spirit not be weak when you are meant to pray the burdens of your heart into manifestation. Jesus was praying to bat his purpose, and he called his disciples to go with him to the garden of Gethsemane, and he said, come and pray with me that I may be able to bath the purpose of God. But as he was praying, he came back. He said, they were sleeping. He went again to pray. He came back, they were sleeping. May your destiny help us that are meant to agree with you in prayer for the release of the plan and purpose of God in your life, not sleep when they are meant to be awake, in the name of Jesus. Peter was about to miss his purpose, and Jesus was there to pray for him. He said, Peter, the devil, Satan wants to sift you like a shaft, but I have failed for you that your faith faileth not. But unfortunate for Judas, he had nobody to pray for him. I want you to rise up on your feet. Enough is enough of aborting the burdens of God in your life. Enough is enough of trivializing the calling of God in your life. I want you to pray that upon this mountain, these 3 days, every purpose, every burden that you shall put in my heart, Lord, shall begin to manifest. I will encounter your manifest presence in the name of Jesus. People of God, until you are spiritual, you cannot begin to manifest. We are too carnal. Carnality is too much. You need to be serious with the things of God. Your spirituality must be in place for you to experience the encounters of God. You have trivialized the burdens of God for too long. It is now time for you to groan in your spirit. To begin to groan in your spirit. That you may be able to give birth to that purpose. That you may be able to give birth to that purpose. You have aborted enough. How many more abortions are you going to have? How many abortions is your destiny going to have? Enough of aborting the purpose of God. Enough of aborting your destiny. It is time for you to step into the fulfillment.
I have made you so small in my heart. Oh Lord, forgive me. I have believed in a lie that you are unable to help me. But now, oh Lord, I see my wrong. Heal my heart and show yourself strong. And he and with my soul, oh Lord, be magnified. Oh Lord, be magnified.
In the spirit right now. Is somebody groaning in the spirit? Is somebody receiving the burdens of God in his heart? Oh yes, Lord, male sentere zundara male sotrobo.
Jesus said, the spirit is willing,
but the flesh is weak. I will not leave this pulpit without giving opportunity for somebody. You see yourself in that message, and you know that you have aborted burdens. Why? The spirit was willing, but the flesh was weak. But by divine impartation, that weak flesh will be empowered tonight, that you will no longer abort the purpose and the burdens of God in your life. Impartation gives strength. And I want to lay this power mantle on you. In Acts chapter 3, verse 1 to 9, Peter and John met the lame man at the beautiful gate. He was always at the beautiful gate. The bodies were there, but he could not be strength to step into the temple, for the manifestation was not there. He needed to be empowered by impartation so that the burdens in his life would turn to his manifestation. If you are there, you see yourself in this message and you want to be imparted even for manifestation, that you no longer want to abort the burdens of God in your life, I want you to just step out quickly, and by the power of God that is resident in the house, the power of God in whom there is no variableness, neither any shadow of cunning, the power of God to manifest, the power of God to encounter, the power of God will be released upon your life. Peter said, silver and gold I have not, but that which I have I give unto you. Receive that impartation right now. Begin to manifest in your calling every abortion, every abortion of the call, the bodies of God in your life ends tonight. The power to deliver. He said, how shall this be? He said, thou shalt be overshadowed by the power of the Most High God. And you begin to bat destiny. You begin to bat purpose. Receive that same grace. Receive that empowerment in the name of Jesus. Allow yourself to be overshadowed. Allow yourself to be dead to self. Every spirit of hunger, every yoke of the flesh that has hindered you from being who God has called you to be, by the power of the Most High God, I impart you with fresh grace in the name of Jesus. I impart you with fresh grace in the name of Jesus. I impart you with fresh grace in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. Male son turbo. Le sentere zundara mama le son turbo. Le sentere zundara mama. Yes, if the same spirit that raised up Jesus from the dead is in your body, that same spirit will quicken your mortal body. Every weakness of the flesh, by this impartation, you are empowered. Your encounter begins from now. I say your encounters begin from now. Your encounters begin from now. In the name of Jesus, begin to manifest to your world. Begin to manifest to your generation. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. Listen to me. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, yes, Lord. Your daughter is here, Lord. Her heart is ready to receive the impartation. Yes, Lord. Overshadow her with the power from the Most High, so that she begins to manifest destiny. I impart you with the Spirit of God. I impart you with the Spirit of God. The manifest presence of God goes with you all the days of your life in the name of Jesus. Receive it. 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 Male son torobo zundarale sentere. Oh, yes, Lord. He said, upon Mount Zion, there shall be holiness and there shall be deliverance. Yes, Lord. The power to deliver, to bat our destiny, impart on her right now in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. The Bible says, out of the body of Paul, handkerchiefs was taken, mantles were taken. And the power of God was there to impart, to heal, and to deliver. I release that same grace now. Enter into your prophetic office. Enter into your prophetic grace in the name of Jesus. You will no longer abort the burdens of God in your life in the name of Jesus. Begin to walk in the calling of God upon your life and your destiny. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It is done. Somebody say it is done.
It is done.
Somebody say it is done.
It is done.
Somebody say it is done.
It is done.
Put your hands together and you may please be seated. In his presence.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. We give glory to God. Amen. Zion encounter. Zion encounter. Zion encounter. Yes, we are possessing our possessions. This is just the beginning. Great things are going to happen in Jesus' name. Amen. And now very quickly, without wasting any minute, I want us to do something very personal, which Abraham did. And he decided he'll not even consult his wife. And he took two of his servants on this journey to go and offer a sacrifice unto the Lord. Prepare your offering. Prepare your seed. Prepare that gift you have purposed to come and worship God with. You know, when I was reading that book and I saw Abraham with these two young servants of his, and the Bible says he never told them what was going to happen. And he told them when he got to the place of the mountain, he said, stay here until I come back. Because giving an offering unto the Lord is a personal, personal thing. Amen? Amen. The Bible says Abraham did not even consult with his wife Sarah. Because he never knew. Should have said, no, you know, this is the only one we have. But he went to give unto the Lord in obedience. So we want to give unto the Lord in obedience because gold and silver belongs unto the Lord. Haggai 2 verse 8. All this silver, gold belongs unto God. We want to come before him and worship him with gladness of heart because he has given us and we cannot outgive him. He is the best giver. He gives you nothing but the best. And so if you have your offering ready, you can send by text. The number will be there on the screen, 559-205-7443. You can write your check to Covenant of Faith Family Ministries. You can also send your offering by Cash App, $ Covenant Faith Family, $Covenant Faith Family. That is our Cash App. And even you can do the same by PayPal. Some of our beloved brethren from all over the world, we receive your gifts through PayPal and we thank God for you. So let's give thanks before we come before God to give. Father, we thank you for putting a substance in our hands, oh God. We do not take this for granted because, Lord, you are the one who gives power to make wealth according to your word in Deuteronomy 8 and 18. Lord, we thank you for you have given us the power to make wealth. And Lord, we know that we are doing this in obedience, not because you are in need of money, but because our destinies are tied to the obedience when it comes to this personal act of worship, oh Lord. So Lord, we pray tonight that you are going to bless each and every family, Lord, going to bless each and every brother, every sister. This substance, oh God, let it bring remembrance before you, Lord, that your children did this in obedience, and let them be blessed in the name of Jesus, that they will not lack, but they will receive more in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, and we bless your name. In Jesus' name we give thanks. Amen. Amen. So when you come dancing. Amen. Here we give unto the Lord gladly. Hallelujah. Amen.
Guest minister to come and bless the offering. I also bless the people of God. I know you want to hear from him tonight. You want to get some blessing, right? You want some prophetic blessing from him. So please put your hands together as I welcome Dr. Tade Owoyemi, our guest minister all the way from Tampa, Florida. to come and bless us as we close the service shortly after that.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Have you been blessed tonight? I have been blessed. So it shows that before there is an encounter, you have to desire it. So which means your level that you are right now, you have to get dissatisfied with it. Amen? So you shouldn't just be saying, okay, that's it. No, get angry with your present circumstance. Then and go ahead and pursue for that change. Because God is always God of encounter. Tell you, Jacob can wrestle with the Lord, as the man of God said, throughout. And he wouldn't let the angel go until there was a word from the angel that changed his life forever. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. So please meditate upon those things, because it is not just enough for us to hear it. Go back and listen to the message on the church Facebook page. Amen. Because that's how we're going to get the benefits of it. You know, so that means you go back, you listen to it, you look, search the scriptures. The scriptures that the man of God said, you search it. What is it that you are doing? You are getting the encounter. I'm telling you. Because it's getting done into your spirit, man. You just know that my change has come. You just know, without anybody telling you. You just know that my change has come. That my level has changed. Why? Because the word has found you. Or you have found the word, and the word has have a place in your life. Amen. Because that's the purpose of this program. And an encounter. Because there is something that the Lord has blessed you with, but you have to go ahead and possess it. Amen. We say Zion encounter. Zion encounter. See that? We're saying I'm possessing my possessions. So the possessing is a deliberate. You have to act on it. Get angry with yourself, present circumstance. God, there is no limit through which we can go with the Lord. But you can set a limit on yourself by not going after what is rightfully yours. Amen. So tell yourself, say, I will go after what is rightfully mine. What God has done for me in Christ, what is mine, the devil cannot take it. I'm going to hold on to it like a bulldog. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. We give you praise for tonight. We thank you for the word. We thank you, God, for the man of God that you have used for us. Lord, we pray for more anointing, a refilling, a more utterance, miraculous utterance of God, and miraculous power demonstrations in his life and in his ministry. We thank you for the new level that you are taking us onto in this this 4-day program. About 5 meetings program. Yes, Friday, Saturday morning, Saturday night, Sunday morning, Sunday night. That's 5 days. Well, thank you, God. We are ready to have a serious encounter with you. And so, Lord, I stretch forth my hands upon everyone that are here, even everyone that are watching over the internet, that, Lord, they will discover that which you have for them this week in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will help every one of us not to miss that word that will change our life this week, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, may your grace be made abundant over us this week in the name of Jesus. And so, Father, your word says, give and it shall be given unto us. Lord, we have given out of what you have given unto us with joy, with love. Lord, we receive the blessings upon our giving right now in the name of Jesus. We command the enemy to take his hands off our money. We command ministry angels to go forth and cause our harvest to come to us in the name of Jesus. We will know no lack in our lives in the name of Jesus. Lord, no more poor, no more lack in our lives in the name of Jesus. Your grace will keep abounding towards us and will abound unto every good works that you, God, has designed us for in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name, Lord Jesus. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen. Glory to God.
Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody say, I am set for my Zion encounter. I am possessing my possessions. I am set for my Zion encounter. I am possessing my possession. I will not abort the burdens of God in my life. In the name of Jesus, it is done. People of God, this is 1 out of 5. 1 out of 5. We shall be gathered again 11 a.m. tomorrow. And we will be gaining access to secrets of ministry. Secrets of ministry. What it takes to be fruitful in the ministry God has committed into your hands. And we shall be having a few sessions, and there will be opportunities for questions and answers where God will be helping us to see how we channel the resource he has given unto us to bring profitability in the ministry God has committed into our hands. Every son of God has a ministry. Remember, I don't say child. Every son of God has a ministry. A child will be walking around and be seated in the pew for years and will just be there in the pew. But a son has a calling, a ministry that will have be activated. He said a child is given, but a child is born and a son is given. Hallelujah. So tomorrow, 11 a.m., I look forward to seeing all the faces I see here. And not just your face, bring somebody along. The same thing tomorrow evening, 5 p.m., is our wonder night, right? If I'm right, it is our wonder night. We will see wonders and deliverance night. Remember, upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance. So every age-long issue that has kept you from fulfilling your destiny, from possessing your possession, will be broken and will be defeated on this mountain in the name of Jesus. So this 3 days, if you can commit it to a day of separating yourself unto God, the burdens is being released right now. Now it is time for you to separate. These 3 days, make it for God. See what God wants to do with you. See what God wants to accomplish with you. And I know that you will not escape the manifest presence of God in the name of Jesus. We are in an attitude of prayer and fasting. Today is day 19. And we are going to 21. So if you have not joined us, why not? Join us starting from tomorrow. And we will end it together on Sunday. And it will be an amazing experience in the name of Jesus. Somebody say amazing experience. Somebody say amazing experience. So quickly, Saturday 11 a.m. Then Saturday 5 p.m. And on Sunday we'll be here 11 a.m. for the word encounter service. And in the evening at 5 p.m. we will be having the Holy Ghost and the miracle night. Hallelujah. Your miracle is taking place in this place in the name of Jesus. So I just want you to lift up your hands. I just appreciate God for the privilege to be in his presence tonight. Give him praise. Give him all the glory. Return all the honor unto him. He is alone is worthy. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Lord, for how far you helped us tonight. Thank you, Lord, for the outpouring of your spirit. Thank you, Lord, for your manifest presence. Lord, we are hungry for you. We want more of you, Lord. And Lord, as we separate ourselves upon this mountain, our encounters shall begin to manifest in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father, as we begin to possess our possession. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. We are head of the Father. We have joined with the Son. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Peace. See you tomorrow, and make sure you take some snacks before you go. God bless you.